Okay, so I ran the tap through here and got them cleaned out. Everything looks good. Now I've got that dropped off bolt that I had cut off. It's down in the bottom here and I need to get it out. So what I did is I just took a stick and just wedged a little magnet in the end, and there it is. So just I didn't want to use a real powerful magnet or it would have, grabbed the sides and stuff, but okay, so let me put these posts in here, tighten them down, and now I should be able to bend this one pretty easily and clamp the top and get everything exactly parallel for the sleeved pieces. So here's that post at the bottom, and see where I cut it apart, and I've got this nice big gap in here now with bright fresh metal, and I'm just gonna come in and I'm just gonna tack it here at the top, the other side, and then I'm just gonna stitch it and try to get as much penetration on both sides as I can down in here, and that'll be good enough for this. And I've got it, let me pull away and I'll show you how I've got this kind of clamped in place. So I've got that piece that I'm going to use there, clamped to the bottom, and then wedged up underneath here. And then I've got my distance set by using this piece of plywood in between. So this is the fixed side, the welded side, and both of them are bolted into place, pinned in place with bolts. And I'm just using that piece of plywood as a stretcher to hold it in place. I want to show you, so here's the piece that I cut on the drill press. That's as far down as I could cut with the hole saw. But that's okay because I'm going to be able to free it with the porta band. Now, what I did here on the other side is, see, the power of the porta band is so incredible because you're able to use it. So when I cut this off, not only am I cutting this off to get rid of that, but I'm also going to, instead of just cutting it like this or back along that line, I'm actually going to cut and bevel it like this, because that's going to be the bevel for the weld. So I'm not going to even have to grind that. I'll just clean this junk off here, that scale and what have you, with my wire wheel, so I don't contaminate my weld. But look how nice this is going to look now. So when this piece of pipe comes in here, I'll just weld it flush to the top, and all the welding will get done on the bottom, on this bottom around here. That's where I'll grind a bevel in here and weld that, and then weld along this connection point right here. So the porta band already, it's just hard for me to hold it and so you can see it. I'm looking in the camera. So you can see the porta band already got it right for me. So I'll just clamp this upside down, put this in, square it up, clamp it in place, and then weld it on my welding table. And then the next thing I've got to do is I'm gonna drill through here. I got my exact distance, so it's gonna be the exact same center line distance as on the angle iron. And then these will all just get welded together. And but before I do that, I'm gonna take a little bit of power that I still have set up on the drill press, because I need to drill 2 3/8-inch holes in this, and I'll just use the cross slide table that I have set up, because I need to weld my nuts and bolts on here. So I'll do that right now before I break that setup down. Really like this stuff. It kind of stinks, and it's sticky and gooey on your hands, but man, it cuts, makes stuff cut. It's the consistency of honey, so it doesn't sling stuff everywhere, which is really nice. I don't mean to keep harping on this, you know, if you, but these, I just want you to really see these step clamps, because these things really are, you know, these really make a drill press. I mean, what they do for little guys like us that, you know, that don't have milling machines yet, I mean, they really... Okay, so I got all my parts ready to weld up the sleeved part on the top, and you can see that I've got my area bright and clean for my new for the bolt that's gonna make for the height adjustment here, and I've got the bottom side. I'm only gonna weld the bottom side onto the pipe, and the pipe is all bright and clean. You know, well, I may weld it on the top too. I'm not sure. It just depends. This is not that thick, so I think I would run the risk of maybe busting through it unless I was real careful. But here, let me show you. Don't want to lose that bolt. So here I've got the, you know, you can see how I've got, you know, I'm going to weld on the inside here, and I've got the bevel all cleaned here, and I did that with the die grinder and one of these burrs. So that just cuts metal like crazy. You know, it's hard to get in there with a traditional angle grinder. So that's all ready to go, and you can see I wire brushed and used the grinder to make sure that all the contamination near the weld. So as that incredible heat goes into this, that all this grease and oil and slag and what have you doesn't bubble up and vaporize and then and get trapped in my weld, which makes for a weaker weld. So that's, you can get some porosity and some other negative consequences from that. So I'm gonna weld these, I'm gonna put these nuts on first. That's the first thing I'm gonna do, is get the nuts on, because I want them to face the inside. So I want to, you know, get them on and, you know, make sure that I get everything oriented right, and then I'll show you my setup here, the clamping setup I've got going on my welding table. Okay, I'm kind of losing the light here, so I gotta do this fast and then weld this up before I lose the light. So what I've got here is I've got the angle iron clamped down to this board with a straight edge, and I've got some distance spacers that I cut, and then that clamp there is pinning them this way, and then I've got these other boards making sure that I'm in the right plane. And, you know, I just kind of got everything just kind of racked right, just checked for squareness everywhere, looks good. You know, came in here, checked my ends. You know, I'm pretty darn close. That looks good. Let me see if that's close. I mean, so what I want to do is I don't want to like come in here and put all that heat energy into one thing. I want to tack, 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 you know, kind of bounce around, and then, you know, I can start checking squareness, and if I have to, like, take the clamps off and rack this thing before I put a full penetration on it, I can do it. So I want to, you know, that's the thing. You don't want to put too much heat energy into something that, you know, unless it's absolutely necessary, because you will get movement. So the last thing I got to do is make some handles for these nuts, and I just, you know, dug in my scrap. So I'm just going to grind around where I've got these marks here. I'll weld this on while I have, you know, grind the top of this, you know, bevel this up, get some bright fresh steel, and then I'll just, after I get it welded on, I'll just I'll cut this here and then cut it here. I like to have the handle a little bit bigger this way, so it'll be fine. I like to not waste anything. Then I'll just kind of grind and shape these so they're real comfortable. Then I can start using this thing. I'll wait till I paint it, wait to paint it until I'm painting a bunch of other stuff, but I can use it now. All right, so let's see it go down on here first for the first time. See if it fits. Oh, wow. You know, that nasty old pipe, it works just fine. So let me tighten this guy down. Some of my homemade handles here. I can always bob this off if I need to later, you know, but I think a lot of times, you know, it's not panels that are coming out here. It's going to be stock like that, but I can always lop this off. These are, like I said, these are just pieces I had already. So let me put some tools in the tray. Oh yeah, that's nice. You can't have enough places to store stuff while you're working. Very nice. I like it a lot. I'll just wait, like I said, I'll just wait till I have some more stuff, and I'll prime this with that Kim Chromic and get it all painted up some crazy color. I got blue and green Sherwin-Williams industrial paint that I'm going to paint stuff with. But that'll work. And I like this because, you know, I can put things like this on it and clamp it and then create actually extensions if I need to. So that's why I put that angle iron on the front. And of course this is reversible, it doesn't matter, the distance is the same, so I just happen to put it on this way to start off with. And so yeah, it's nice.